الرحيم الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله brothers sisters and everyone السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته and welcome back. So just before the break we were talking about this issue of one of the scholars. He changed his views and he is saying that istighatha is not shirk but it is a major sin and it should be avoided. I was speaking about this issue in general first. I said, first of all, let us be careful of the labels. Yeah. The second point is, let us not call someone that he has a different aqidah or corrupted aqidah just because he disagrees with us. And the third point I would like to mention is, who are the scholars that we take from? Yeah, I'll give you just two main conditions. The first one is that this scholar is well known that his khair, okay, is more than the mistakes he makes. Yeah, the goodness that comes from him overweighs, okay, the goodness, yeah, overweighs the mistakes that happened or he might fall in. Okay, this is one thing. The other thing is that this point, by the way, includes that normally he says correct things, but he might have said one or two wrong things here or there. Okay, and many people fall into the such mistakes. Generally speaking, he is good. Yeah. And you can, what he says normally is in conformity with the mainstream Islam. So this is one condition. Yeah. And this will be well known, by the way, brothers, that, oh, this scholar, mashallah, and we benefited from him. And he always say things that are good, etc., within, in conformity within the Islamic guidelines. He might have certain views here and there, okay, but that doesn't negate the fact that his khair and goodness, okay, overwhelms the mistakes, such mistakes. The second point is that when I listen to him, okay, listen to this, brothers and sisters, when I listen to him or I mix with him or I take from him, yeah, I become closer to Allah Jalla Ala, number one, yeah. Number two, I become more active in my ibadah. Okay? Number three, my akhlaq improves. Okay? So, I become closer to Allah Jalla Ala, I become more active in ibadah, and my akhlaq, generally dealing with people, okay, becomes better. Okay? And other positive things come out because I listen to him. But if I listen to him and I become away from Allah Jalla Ala, I do not become more active in ibadah, or my akhlaq, my character becomes worse, then there is something wrong there. Okay, so this is the second condition. So these are two conditions for the scholars that you take from them. And alhamdulillah, by the grace of Allah Jalla Ala, most of the scholars that are well known and well accepted by the community, they are of that caliber. Yeah? Different schools of thoughts, that is normal. We cannot avoid that. And this leads to my second point, which is my next point. Because brothers and sisters, especially I would like to address our scholars, because our scholars, they belong to different schools of thoughts. I would like them to focus on what is agreed upon and don't bring controversial issues. It is not because your madhab says this, you negate all other opinions and you want all people to follow your madhab or your school of thought or your ideas or your the school of thought you belong to. No, promote what we all as Muslims agree upon. Now, if there are minor differences, then you might adopt them. If there are major differences, then I advise not to discuss them within the public. Okay, discuss with public what increases their iman, what makes them closer to Allah Jalla Ala, what makes them more effective Muslims, what makes them better Muslims in terms of character. Okay, positive things, and don't go into the details and the technicalities. This is my advice to all scholars. This is also my advice to that scholar in America and this scholar here or there, everyone. I hope that they appreciate this and they listen, or at least they think of this advice and they take it seriously. Because when you go into much details, technicalities, this will divide people. And people will not understand those things as they should be understood. The Prophet ﷺ says, حَدِّثُ النَّاسَ بِمَا يَعْرِفُونَ. Talk to people what they can understand. And the Prophet ﷺ also said to Aisha, hadn't your people close to kufr, because they just left kufr, then I would have demolished the Kaaba and rebuilt it according to the foundations of Ibrahim. So the Prophet ﷺ didn't do this because he doesn't want to create fitna among his people. Look, this is the Prophet ﷺ, yeah? Let alone that the other people. And these are the companions of the Prophet ﷺ. And also, مَا أَنْتَ مُحَدِّثٍ قَوْمًا حَدِيثًا إِلَّا كَانَ لِبَعْضِهِمْ فِتْنَةً. Sometimes you might talk to people in a way that they do not understand it or they do not appreciate it, and it will be fitna for them. So avoid that. And نَهَا عَنِ الْأُغْلُوطَاتِ, etc., etc. There are so many evidence that that support this principle, which is talk to people on matters they can understand, matters of agreement between the scholars, and don't go into much technicalities and details regarding the differences between the ummah, because such differences, especially if they are related to some aqidah issues, they might lead to disunity between people. Now, regarding the last point, I would like to take the callers. Now, the last point regarding making dua to other than Allah Jalla Ala. Yeah? Now, brothers and sisters, again, I don't want to go into the technicalities of this, but I would like just to ask you, okay? Just ask you simple questions, rational questions. Who is the one who always sees you? Allah. Who is the one who is always hearing you? Allah Jalla Ala. As-Sami al-Basir. Do we have any confirmation of any saint? Yeah, even do we have any confirmation that the Prophet ﷺ always hears us and sees us? No, we don't have confirmation. It is not mentioned in the Quran at all. If someone were to say that it is mentioned in the Quran, this is his interpretation that it is mentioned. But Allah Jalla Ala, he is As-Sami'ul Basir. Yeah, okay, who can do things? Yeah. It is Allah Jalla Ala, wa huwa ala kulli shayin qadir. Yeah, he is the one who overpowers everything. And anything who is able to do something, Allah Jalla Ala is the one who gave them this ability, and it is a limited ability. Allah Jalla Ala says in the Quran, the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam says, as Allah Jalla Ala told us in the Quran, قُلْ لَا أَمْلِكُ لِنَفْسِي ضَرًّا وَلَا نَفْعًا. In one verse, قُلْ لَا أَمْلِكُ لِنَفْسِي نَفْعًا وَلَا ضَرًّا. I don't have any control for myself over anything that either benefits me or harms me. I don't have control over that. The Prophet ﷺ said, إِلَّا مَا شَاءَ اللَّهُ. Yeah? Except what Allah Jalla Ala has given me. The Prophet ﷺ mentioned this as Allah Jalla Ala says in the Quran. Allah Jalla Ala says in the Quran, قُلْ أَرْأَيْتُمْ إِنْ أَصْبَحَ مَاءُكُمْ غَوْرًا فَمَنْ يَأْتِيكُمْ بِمَاءٍ مَعِينٍ. If Allah Jalla Ala were to take the water from you, who else other than Allah Jalla Ala will provide you with water? Yeah? Allah Jalla Ala says, قل أرأيتم إن جعل الله عليكم الليل سرمدا إلى يوم القيامة من إله غير الله يأتيكم بضياء. If Allah Jalla wa'ala were to make the entire days and nights as nights or as days, who is other than Allah Jalla wa'ala is able to change that? Okay? And so on and so forth. We can talk about this. Allah Jalla wa'ala says, وَإِنْ يَمْسَسْكَ اللَّهُ بِضُرٍّ فَلَا كَاشِفَ لَهُ إِلَّا هُوْ. Yeah? وَإِنْ يَمْسَسْكَ بِخَيْرٍ فَلَا رَدَّ لِفَضْلِهِ. If any harm were to touch you, no one can remove it except Allah Jalla wa'ala. And also Allah Jalla wa'ala mentioned that the disbelievers themselves, when they are during the time of hardship, they acknowledge that no one can help them except Allah Jalla wa'ala. فَإِذَا رَكِبُوا فِي الْفُلْكِ دَعُوا اللَّهَ مُخْلِصِينَ لَهُ الدِّينَ. When they are in the sea and the wind is about to hit them, they will ask Allah Jalla wa'ala, Allah Jalla wa'ala مُخْلِصِينَ لَهُ الدِّينَ. Yeah? When Allah Jalla wa'ala saves them, then they will commit shirk. But مُخْلِصِينَ لَهُ الدِّينَ means they will not ask other than Allah Jalla wa'ala in times of difficulties. Sorry, I have another caller, but we can go on and talk about this. That's why Allah Jalla wa'ala says, because of that Allah Jalla wa'ala, He is the Lord, He controls everything. He controls the risk. Yeah? Allah, هو الرزاق ذو القوة المتين. Okay? ما أريد منكم من رزق وما أريد أن تطعمون إن الله هو الرزاق ذو القوة المتين. Allah جل وعلا is the one who cures us. Allah جل وعلا is the one who gives us رزق. Allah جل وعلا is the one who controls everything. So, now, because of this, Allah جل وعلا says in the Quran, وقال ربكم ادعوني أستجب لكم إن الذين يستكبرون عن عبادتي. Okay, سيدخلون جهنم داخلي. Allah Jalla wa'ala says, ask me, don't ask someone else. Okay, and those who show arrogance against, and Allah Jalla wa'ala called dua here as ibadah, يستكبرون عن عبادتي, which means that the dua is the essence of ibadah. And actually, this was mentioned in one of the hadith, the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, and the member, he was giving a sermon. He said, إِنَّ الدُّعَاءَ هُوَ الْعِبَادَةِ وَقَالَ رَبُّكُمْ. And then he quoted this ayah. So the Prophet ﷺ says, dua is the essence of ibadah. And then he quoted this ayah. And also Allah Jalla wa'ala says, وَلَا تَدْعُ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ مَا لَا يَنْفَعُكَ وَلَا يَضُرُّكَ فَإِنْ فَعَلْتَ فَإِنَّكَ إِذًا مِنَ الظَّالِمِينَ وَإِنْ يَمْسَسْكَ اللَّهُ بِضُرٍّ فَلَا كَاشِفَ لَهُ إِلَّا هُوَ. Yeah? Don't ask other than Allah Jalla wa'ala. Don't ask anyone beside Allah Jalla wa'ala. If you do so, you are from the zalimin. The zalimin. In the other ayah, Allah Jalla wa'ala says, وَمَنْ أَضَلُّ مِمَّنْ يَدْعُو مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ مَنْ لَا يَسْتَجِيبُ لَهُ إِلَى يَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ وَهُمْ بِدُعَائِهِمْ كَافِرُونَ وَإِذَا حُشِرَ النَّاسُ كَانُوا بِعِبَادَتِهِمْ كَافِرِينَ. Yeah? وَمَنْ أَضَلُّ مِمَّنْ يَدْعُو مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ مَنْ لَا يَسْتَجِيبُ لَهُ إِلَى يَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ وَهُمْ عَنْ دُعَائِهِمْ غَافِلُونَ وَإِذَا حُشِرَ النَّاسُ كَانُوا لَهُمْ أَعْدَاءً وَكَانُوا بِعِبَادَتِهِمْ كَافِرِينَ. وَمَنْ أَضَلُّ. Who is more misguided than the one who is asking other than Allah Jalla wa'ala, beside Allah Jalla wa'ala? And those whom he is asking beside Allah Jalla wa'ala, they are heedless. They don't know about them. And on the day of resurrection, yeah, they will be the enemies of those who were asking them and invoking them. And they will disassociate themselves from their ibadah. Again, Allah Jalla wa'ala called this as a ibadah. وَلَا تَدْعُ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ مَا لَا يَنْفَعُكَ وَلَا يَضُرُّكَ, etc. We can go on and on talking about that, which is what? The fact that Allah Jalla wa'ala wanted us to be connected to Him, brothers, sisters. Yeah? Allah Jalla wa'ala doesn't want anyone to enter as an intermediate between us and Him. So that's why, for example, if the person says, I go to this grave or I go to this saint to ask him So he will intercede before Allah Jalla Ala. We say that, come on. Even if some of the scholars, I don't know whether some scholars said this or not. I don't know. Okay, disclaimer. I don't know. What I know is that none of the scholars have said this. Okay? This is what, when I said I don't know, I mean, yeah, what I know, that all scholars have disagreed with this. Okay? Some of them considered it shirk, some of them considered it a great bid'ah, some of them considered it as a great haram. Yeah? I don't know of anyone who says that it is allowed to go to a grave and to ask the person in the grave. But I'm saying that even if some scholars say that it is allowed, what is better, my dear respected brothers and sisters? Think about it. To ask Allah Jalla Ala directly or to ask the grave? Come on. Yeah? What is better, to go for the method of the Quran or to go for the method of this scholar or that scholar? Yeah? Now, and I said to one time one brother, who told you that this person, he hears you? Yeah? He said, yeah, because he's a saint, etc. I said, does Allah Jalla Ala hear you? Yeah? Yes. So there is a confirmation that Allah Jalla Ala, as I said in the beginning, hears you. And there is no confirmation that this can hear you, as Allah Jalla Ala says in the Quran. And there is no confirmation that this can help you. Okay? وَكَانُوا بِعِبَادَةٍ كَافِرِينَ Yeah? Anyway, the verses that we mentioned in the Quran. So, if there is no confirmation that this can help you, then go for what is clear, which is that Allah Jalla Ala is there, He hears you, and He is the one who can help you, and leave the other things. And wallahi, there is nothing more beautiful than being connected with Allah Jalla Ala and not being connected with the human beings, because at the end of the day, they are human beings. If the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, I don't control anything that benefits me or anything that harms me against Allah Jalla wa Ala will, I don't ala amliku li nafsi naf'an wa la dharra. So imagine about others. Yeah, this is the conclusion of this mas'ala. Of course, we don't have much time to go in much details, but inshallah, this is yani clear. And I would like again to appeal to our scholars, to our du'at, to imams and khatib, to speak about these clear things that connect people to Allah Jalla wa Ala, and to have that kind of feeling, romantic feeling with Allah Jalla wa Ala, rather than with other human beings. Okay.